In today's video, we'll take a look at adding and animating a combination of mask effects to recreate this scene, with a title placed between the sky and the mountain, and a hot air balloon floating by in front of the title. Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Serge, and welcome back to my channel for another tutorial. In my last video, we looked at the basics of masking in Final Cut Pro. We learned how to add a basic shape mask and a more complex draw mask, and how to make all the necessary adjustments. Today, we'll put all that together alongside with some basic keyframing to recreate the clip from this video's intro. If you'd like to learn more about masking or keyframing in Final Cut Pro, I put together a short playlist that'll be linked up top and in the description. Check it out for a more in-depth look at both these effects. Now, let's take a look at making the clip used at the start of this video. We'll start out with a simple clip and a title placed over it. First, to place the title behind the mountain, let's duplicate our clip and place it in the top layer. Next, from the effects browser, add a draw mask to the top clip and add control points to trace the mountain. Since our title only overlaps the top part, we only need to mask off that area. Zoom in the viewer for more precision. Click on the first control point to close the mask. Next, we need to add a draw mask to the hot air balloon and animate it to track the balloon as it moves. Once again, duplicate the original clip and set it as the top layer in your timeline. From the effects browser, add a draw mask again, but this time, before adding any control points, in the inspector, select the shape type as B-Spline. B-Spline curves are used to mask softer and rounder shapes. When adding control points using B-spline curves, rather than placing control points on the shape itself, a curve is formed between the points and is magnetically pulled towards a control point. By combining the influence of multiple B-spline points, you can create different kinds of curves. By default, B-spline curves create very smooth shapes with no corners, although you can create sharper curves if necessary. To adjust the point curvature, hold down the Command key and drag the control point. To make the curve sharper, drag away from the point. To make it looser, command drag towards a point. You can also switch between three progressively sharper degrees of curvature by either command clicking the control point or control clicking and selecting between linear, smooth, or very smooth curvature. So back in our clip, with a playhead over the first frame of the clip, zoom in and add and adjust control points to create a shape around the hot air balloon. Next, in the inspector, with a playhead on the first frame of the clip, add a keyframe to control points and the transform parameters. Next, move your playhead to where the balloon just moves behind the mountain and click and drag the shape over the balloon. Next, skim your clip and adjust the mask position as necessary to trace the subject. Since we've set an initial keyframe, every time you move the mask, an additional keyframe will be added. Let's take a look at the finished result. This is just a few examples of what can be accomplished by using masks in Final Cut Pro. In my opinion, masks are one of the best tools in video editing, and alone are worth the price of upgrading from iMovie. If you found this video helpful, please let me know by hitting the like button below. Ask any questions about this video or any other topic related to Final Cut Pro in the comments below, and somebody will surely help you out. So, thanks for watching. I'll see you back here next week for another Final Cut Pro tutorial.